If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe. Hello everyone, Melcadrien here, and I'm here to show you a creepy castle. This is going to be my first impressions, seeing as I haven't exactly played any of the game at all. I've only basically seen the introductory cutscene, and that's it. The eponymous adventure, Mothin embarks to the creepy castle known as the City of Light, where rumors say a world-threatening conspiracy lurks. Theme, fantasy adventure. I like the old film reel here. On the horizon, a castle, like shadow becomes stone. From its walls seep tales of dark conspiracy within, and to investigate comes the vagrant swordsman, Moth. Coming all this way had been an endeavor on its own, even for a soul of his wanderlust, but the real trial was only beginning, and though he was no stranger to happening upon the shady machinations of conspirators, little could ever suspect the immense gravity of what would transpire in this creepy castle. I swear, that one of those actually kind of looks like a semicolon. I don't know why, but it did. This looks like a training ground. Use your confirm button to read the signs and brush up on your know-how. Okay. I like the old-fashioned style gameplay here. Well, not gameplay, but the visuals. I mean, there are only a few games where I've played things like this. One of them is you have to win the game. You can always use the next and previous item buttons to highlight your action command, depending on context. This is used to attack, open chests, save, and more. Oh, okay. Alright. Attack enemies. Oh, that was easy. Next. Another defeated enemy. We got ourselves a key to open locked doors. Okay, cool. With next and previous item buttons, you can highlight any item you use just like the action command. Keys, open doors, foodstuffs, heal HP, and etc. So basically, the usual stuff. Doors open. Sometimes to get to where you need to go, you'll have to jump off a ledge. Go ahead, it's fine. Okay, going down. Wow, Moth really can take a landing. I mean, the health hasn't dropped at all. Wow. The music changed a bit. Ow. You had one more HP than I thought you had. There's a door. It's locked. Let's go this way then. Oh. Interesting. I guess our save point is across. Whatever they have. Let's see. Hey there, I'm Locke. I'm looking for a certain key. I can tell you about the different kinds of keys. Golden keys like this one are used to open normal doors. And it looks like you've disappeared as well. I guess Locke is just a teleporting key person. Something, anyways. Another squeaker. Oh, what do we have here? I was right to come here. For who knows how long, I have wasted my time stumbling through the night in a hunt of a shadow. But no more. I shall remain right here at the crossroads of fate, poised to strike. Something big is brewing here, and I intend to stir the pot. Monsoon. Well, that makes sense. For years, I have subsisted on rage alone, often with nary a trace of my mark. Yet in the mere days since my arrival, multiple potential leads have presented themselves to me. All I have to do now is pace myself. I shall work towards my new master's ambition, but I must never forget why I am really here. to make your mark. Yes, we all know. That's what I am here for. I want to make a mark on this world. And in order to do that, I must conquer and defeat my enemies. And use them as well. A long day's work will often leave the body wearied. Thankfully, when we lose our stamina, there is a solution to exhaustion. The consumption of food. Ooh. Rice snack, ice cream, apples? Different foods will restore stamina to varying degrees. The extent of a foodstuff's restorative capability is conveyed at the top of the screen, to the right of your level, when a foodstuff is selected. Okay. To consume a foodstuff, press your action button when the appropriate foodstuff is selected. Place the food in your mouth and begin the mastication process. Using your mandibular function, teeth, and tongue to exert to exert force and crush your food. Delicious. When the food is well ground and sufficiently lubricated with saliva, commence It's how to eat, but it's just so ridiculous on how they make it so technical. Commence swallowing by relaxing your throat muscles, opening up your sphincter, and moving the chewed food to the back of your mouth with your tongue. The food will then slide into the esophagus. The automated digestion will follow and nourish your body through absorption of nutrients. Between and after swallowing some foodstuff fragments, be sure to resume breathing. See chapter 1. Have a nice day, Poindexter. You'd rather have an egg, but this plant will do. Oh, it's an eggplant. Okay. It restores 2 HP, but we can eat it right now. Nom, nom. Mm. Delicious. I don't know if those stars mean anything or what, because I don't seem to see any wallets, so. Quick draw. Sometimes when fighting an enemy, a duel will be initiated. They come in quite a few flavors. Quick draw is one such flavor. Wait for the prompt, then hit the confirm button to strike first. Oh, a la Kirby, huh? But don't be too antsy and hit the button before the prompt, or you'll fumble and leave yourself wide open. But also don't be too slow, or you'll just be punched in the face. Yeah, don't want that to happen. Most of the time you'll just punch each other in the face. Try your best. Okay. Got him. We beat him. Oh, we got a leveled up cross or something. I guess those ones are, those ones level us up. Ooh, chocolate. Mmm. So the crosses that we pick up, the gold cross level us up, and the big ones are save points. Good to know. Nice! I punched him in the face first! Sometimes you'll have to struggle to get away from or endure an attack. Just press the left and right buttons alternatively as fast as you can. If you're too slow, there will be painful consequences. Yeah, I do not want to be eaten today. Even if you take damage, don't stop struggling, or else you'll take even more damage. Try your best. Okay. I am not food! I mean, you can be food, but you don't seem to drop food. Poetic Tenant's Diary. What is a fire, a pyre of ire, beauty which should be desired? I think that to which you should aspire, Is that your soul glow like a fire? If only I could be so incandescent. Work all day and night to master Darkling's delights. I burn full of pride. It crackles, it burns, it licks at the air. Fire, fire, the forest's despair. But that's how we get coal, charcoal. And that's how we can... Well, it's a good thing I walked past that before I got my head filled with bricks. Because no one wants a head filled with bricks. We'd be called brickheads. Well, it's been a week at the new place now. I must say, I miss my old place in the barracks. There's this one spot in my roof that falls down no matter how many times I patch it back up. It seems like it always happens when I walk under it. I guess it's the vibrations, maybe. Or it's a trigger or something like that. Apparently, I don't have it the worst here, though. Down the hall, there's a guy who hears terrible poetry recital all day in another... in a overgrown room with a leak. Oh well, I suppose I can try and grin and bear it. What else can I do? Autumn 16th. Okay, no, I can't put up with this. Wow. One day. Well, I've been placed into a room. I've been assigned to menial labor for a place to stay. I must say, things were off to a bit of a shaky start with the whole mold thing, but I'm a little optimistic about this. It's been nice to hang out with Locke again. This castle has a lot of loot, so in between his duties, he's been prowling about and checking everything for the key he wants. Of course, that's just what Locke does after all. I heard about a strange device being built here called a Heartbreaker, and it sounds awfully suspicious. I was afraid there'd be a catch to this place, and I'm starting to fear that the Heartbreaker is that catch. I wonder what exactly that will do. Hello there. My name is Novaki. You seem like you're new here too, huh? I got here about a week ago myself. Wow, is that a sword? You look like you're a professional fighter, or traveler, or something. I guess that's all the dialogue Novaki has. Okay. Onward! Let's go up these stairs. And down these stairs. Why do they design it with such a design? I have no idea. Trap enthusiast, falling down. Carpentry headache or literal headache, page 13. You may feel alarmed when your stronghold falls into disrepair, but don't let that decrepit roof be a threat to your intruders. Only those with quick feet will get away in time, and only perceptive protags will notice the visual differences of a dilapidated ceiling. If it's very visual, yeah, but we were talking about a game that has no visual notification, you're bound to get a headache regardless. See, Hurricane. See you next month with a specialty trap to knock you off your feet. It's a real ball. Stay crafty, trappers. Oh, and there's a QR code right there. I don't have a QR code reader, nor am I going to bother trying to scan that. However, if you guys want to scan that and tell me what it is, I appreciate it. Maybe it's a QR link to the book itself, with the three pages. I'm the first to move into new living accommodations. I have a pretty cozy little joint. I love it. I was a little nervous when people were getting moved out to make room so scientists could sleep closer to their work. But this might be alright. The lead of iOS development moved in next door. He's nice, but I guess he doesn't need to sleep at night because he's made of plasma. So he's kind of noisy. I asked him to keep it down, but I still hear his his poetry reading. I cannot believe it. This hack thinks he's Bugsbear. Every time I ask him to watch the volume or at least the meter, he's back at it again in half an hour. And since he can't use paper, he loudly chisels his poems into tablets. At least I hope it's just tablets. It can't be the walls, right? I fear he's doing terrible things to the structure of both stone and stanza alike. I guess there are some people who have it worse than me here, though. Down one hall, there's a slimy room under a pool, and down another, there's a guy whose ceiling keeps falling on him. Yeah, I've seen that one. Every day of my life is bad poetry. Help. Well, it looks like he just ran out. Moist tenant. Okay. I'm at my new apartment and I have a bad feel about it. There's vines? Like, all over. I'll try cleaning up. I think I can make it work. All the vines are gone. The vines came back, and it's so muggy in here, and the roof started leaking all over this diary, and now the pages are sticky. There's even more vines than there were at the first. It's like a hydra. I feel the vines and I went off to a bad start. I shouldn't have cut them down. They were here first. At least I don't have it like people down the halls from me. One guy is kept up all night by bad poetry or something, and the other guy has got like 5 concussions because his roof is falling apart and it keeps nailing him. Oh, I feel sorry for them. Yeah, that's not gonna work since I just walked straight on by. Let's see. We have this one. Let's fight this one. Which one next? Angry tenants. Oh man, where do I start today? My living conditions in the worst apartment ever continue as terribly as expected. They assured me that I'd get nothing but the best accommodation in the castle. Ha! What a joke! I turned on the tap and water came rushing out immediately, and it didn't stop until I had turned it off again. Ah, this is crazy! Can't they see how dangerous it is? What if someone broke into my place and turned it on just to drown me? I can't believe they failed to account for that. Yesterday, I opened my window, revealing an amazing sight of the nature on the outside of the castle and flooding the room with sunlight. What is this madness? How could I ever convince myself to go outside in my free time now that I have access to something almost as good from the comfort of my room? They're clearly trying to assassinate my long-term health and fitness. I can't believe I have to live in this squalor when the people down the halls have it so good. One guy gets to hear poetry anytime he wants, for free. That stuff isn't even released in print yet. Another has an infinite supply of top quality all-natural vines. I am green with envy. But that's not even the worst. One of them literally lives in a convertible. He can remove the roof whenever he wants. My roof can't do that. This is discrimination. I'll raise heck with these dung beetles in management. So, he's angry because he's got it good. Or maybe he's angry because he didn't get it good. Maybe he's just very inversive. I don't know. You will never eat me! I'll beat you up, though. Oh, I got a copper sword. Half XP. And a key. Well, it's time to eat some chocolate. Nom 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 nom. Mmm, delicious. Yep, you sure got slugged. Ooh, pizza. How about a pizza this? Yeah, I would love a pizza that. And fire. Nice. sometimes you and your enemy will find yourselves locked, trying to push back each other back. Press the display buttons in order and shove your enemy back and leave them vulnerable. If you're not fast enough, you'll get shoved over yourself. Try your best. Okay, sure. Nice. Round two. Okay. Ow. You critted me there. Not nice, dude. Oh, and another key. Well, at least I'm recovered. And I got keys to boot. Yeah! Let's continue onwards. I believe there are some... Oh, there are locked doors over there, but... I haven't been over here yet. What do we have over here, huh? Oh, a snake. You know what? I'll ignore the enemies first. Let's check out what's over here, huh? Three locked doors. So it looks like I have to go this way. Bam. Okay. Hold on. Okay, thank you for waiting. Alright, what do we have here? Basic training. People you can converse with have a speech bubble above their heads. I already know that. Many of multiple messages. When you have exhausted conversation, the speech bubble disappears. Okay. Have you come to investigate what's going on around here? It's getting dangerous. I'm going to escape. You would be wise to do the same. Good thing I can use the map by pressing the pause button to take a look at where I've been. Where you've been, huh? Nope, that's the wrong one. Huh. There's a little golden thing, a little yellow thing up there. I assume that's the save point, but let's make sure. Yes, it is. These yellow marks are the save points. However, it doesn't allow me to teleport wherever I want to. Oh well. Anyways. Let's use this last key and see what is lying down here. Ow. Shrimp? And cake. I can't eat this. It's looking at me. You really take the cake. Or took it. Sure, it's looking at me, but once you boil it, I don't think you're gonna be worried too much about it. Oh! Looks like we have the, looks like we have an evil lord in front of us. You? What are you doing here? It seems that fate has destined our weapons to clash once more. Yes! Come on! Ah! Ow. Gotcha. Certainly has a good grip. But at least I'm the faster draw. Yeah! We have beaten Monsoon! We are victorious! Victory is ours! So, what is our reward? A level up? And a... bagel! Can't say no to a bagel. Did we just fall out of the creepy castle? And fall into another creepy castle? I do believe we have. So, this is a very creepy castle. Not only did we fall out of one creepy castle, but we have entered another creepy castle to match it. With an interesting tile set to go with it, too. Can't wait to check out this place. Unfortunately, this is where I'm gonna have to end our video. So, what do I think about Creepy Castle? It certainly is interesting. So, this is Melcadrien, and this has been my impressions of Creepy Castle. If this video has interested you to check out the game for yourself, awesome. If not, well then I hope I at least entertained you. So, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment down below, follow me on Twitter and or Tumblr if you want to. I do, however, appreciate it a whole lot. Thank you. You all have a wonderful day, and happy gaming.